Really? Really? That's attractive? Either I'm losing my touch with the common folk, or I don't know. This is Mortal Instruments, City of Bones. Okay, let's get some history around this. City of Bones is part of the Mortal Instruments book series that was written by Cassandra Clare in 2007. The book was a bit of a hit, so it was only a matter of time really until the movie was made. When I watched the trailer, I had a feeling I'd seen all the stuff in it before. Well, my thoughts went wrong, as the film is full of cliches and rip-offs from other franchises. But before I go into all that, let's see what it's all about. So our leading lady Clary, played by Lily Collins, is an ordinary New York teenager, or that's what she's always been led to believe. But then she witnesses a brutal murder in a nightclub that no one else notices, and her mother Jocelyn is kidnapped. Clary learns the astonishing truth from Jace Wayland, who is played by Jamie Campbell-Bauer, that there is another world alongside her own that humans, or mundanes, doesn't that sound familiar, cannot see, filled with demons, warlocks, vampires, and werewolves. Oh my! Like Jace, Clary's bloodline is that of a shadow hunter. These half-angel warriors protect the human world from demons. The stakes could not be higher as humanity faces imminent extinction, and Clary unwittingly holds the key to survival. Now, when I went into this, as I said, I had very much a Twilight sort of mindset on. Because when you see the trailers, you think, God, this just looks like another Twilight. And it is. It is essentially another Twilight film. You watch it and all the cliches come out, like, oh, he plays a piano because he's a tortured soul. And of course, the friend Simon, that's who hangs around with Clary, of course he's in love with her. And then she meets the shadow hunter called Jason. Of course they fall in love, because that's what happens in all these books. I really hope this trend dies out soon, because it's not just going to be us moaning people who don't like Twilight. People are going to eventually get bored of this, like every other sort of fad. So let's start with our leading lady, Clary, who is doing an excellent Bella Swan impression with her mouth half open all the time and essentially just being a damsel in distress. Okay, I'm getting bored of this now. Seriously, having your mouth half open does not make you attractive. I think that's the problem at the moment. Everyone just wants a piece of the Twilight fortune, so films are being made just to cash in on the similarities. Ugh, God. God, there were so many times during this I had just rolled my eyes during this. Now, I'm going to talk about, well, like I said, of course, there has to be a love triangle, so we have our two guys here. Now, like I said at the start, this is attractive. Really? This is attractive nowadays? It's like that other movie which I said it takes a lot from, Twilight. Of course, let's just take these two away for a second. Let's put the Twilight guys up. Okay, so on this side, we have, of course, Shovel Face, as we all know who he is. And on this side, we have, well, let's just call him Muscles, because I'm sorry, I think his name's Taylor Lautner, I think. I could be wrong. I'm sorry if I'm wrong. But that's all you were. That's all you were. People didn't look at your face. When you took off your shirt and you showed your body, that's all you were. You were just there to be Muscles. So these guys weren't attractive. And then we get these two for this film. Now this one I like to call Fish Face, because he looks like a fish. And then this guy, Peter Parker. And this brings me to the main problem of the film, is that the tone of the film. It shifts so frequently that you don't know where you stand. So we have a romance where everything's all nice and lovey, and then we get to the dark, gritty world of the Shadow Hunters. Then we also get a magical edge in the similar vein to Harry Potter, so it really doesn't know what tone it wants to have. So how does the boy wizard come into this? Well, there's a place called the Institute, and when it was introduced in the film, I couldn't help but think, it's Hogwarts. Then they open the main doors. It looks pretty much like the main entrance to Hogwarts. Then we meet the leader of the Shadow Hunters, Hodge, who is described as an eccentric. Then they open his office doors, and we get an office similar to Dumbledore. Also, human folk are called mundanes. God, you couldn't make it sound any closer to Muggle, could you? I believe that people who are fans of the book are not too pleased with it, I believe. If you're into your Twilights, you'll probably enjoy this. But someone like me who's tried Twilight and hated it, you're gonna hate this as well. Like I said, it does get kind of fun, but it's nothing to shout home about. But these guys are attractive. Someone please tell me how these guys are attractive. I don't know. But anyway, I don't know when I'm going to be back doing another one, but I felt like I had to say something about this awful thing. So, thanks very much for watching, take care, and I'll talk to you soon.